In this video, we will be breaking down the do's and don'ts of how to film your research video. Welcome back. This is part 2 of 3 of a video series that will help you share your research through video. Last time we talked about creating a story arc for your video, answering 3 questions. What is the research project you're working on? How does this apply to your audience? What is one point you would like your audience to know? If you missed that video, you can check it out here in the description below. Today we're going to give you 7 simple suggestions on how to film your research video. Even better, you don't have to have a fancy camera. You can just use your phone. First, turn your phone sideways. This is so you can achieve the most cinematic and natural looking footage when you're filming. An exception to this rule would be if the platform you're premiering your footage on is mainly vertical, for example, an Instagram story. Second, keep it steady. Use both hands to stabilize your phone when you're filming. Lock your elbows into your body. Your body will then act as a tripod and you will have much more stabilization in your shot. If you want motion, lock your elbows and move your entire upper body with the camera while keeping your feet locked to the ground. Third, the rule of thirds. The theory is that if you place points of interest in the intersections or along the lines, that your photo or video becomes more balanced and will enable a viewer of the video to interact with it more naturally. Four, work with light and not against it. If you're outdoors, make sure that you find a spot where the sun is evenly lighting either the subject or the scene you want to film. For example, windows can act as a natural softbox to diffuse some of the harsh sunlight. If some parts of the shot are looking too bright or too dark, change your position or angle to achieve the shot that you want, so that you are working with the light and not against it. 5. Strive for shot variety. You can highlight smaller details and not just the overall scene. It can be as simple as shooting your subject from both close up and further away so you can capture from a variety of angles. A bunch of smaller clips made into an entire video is much more interesting than one singular take. 6. Manually set exposure and focus. With a smartphone, the most important is the AE, or auto exposure function, which prevents the exposure from changing on your smartphone when you're filming. Press and hold an area of the screen to activate the AE-AF lock function. 7. Check your mic. Move close to your subject to avoid picking up as much ambient noise as possible. Make sure your hand placement is not covering your camera's microphone. If you're filming with your phone, be sure to switch it on to airplane mode to make sure that you get no notifications while you're recording. Next time, we'll give you step-by-step instructions to make editing your video something you can do on your own.